डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ शशांक शेखर शुक्ला, टीचर आप सीता चिल्ड्रन अकेडमी। एज यू नो दैट वैकेशंस आर रनिंग ड्यू टू वन डेडली डिजीज कोरोना वायरस, दैट्स वाई सम स्टेप्स हैज बीन टेकन बाय अवर स्कूल्स टू प्रोवाइड सम क्लासेस बाय यूट्यूब चैनल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वॉन्ट टू टेल सम पॉइंट्स about the disease of coronavirus, how to avoid it. First of all, students, wash your hands before eating. Before taking anything, wash your hands minimum 20 seconds before eating and after eating. Use sanitizer, use mask if you are going anywhere outside of your house. First of all, you have to pay attention properly. Follow complete lockdown as our Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi has also requested us that we should not go anywhere outside of the house to avoid the coronavirus. So follow the complete lockdown, stay at home, be safe and enjoy at the home. We are going to provide you some different topics. As you will read it, you will watch it, and you can enhance your knowledge. In the sequence, I would tell you some important topics in English. As you know that in English, we learn a lot of things. The basic things I will tell you today. The thing is, you have read about the words, about the sentence. Today I will tell you about the parts of speech. You know that parts of speech in Hindi we say it shabd bhed. As you know that any language it made by different type of words. All the words played their role to form any topic, any language. So in this sequence I will tell you first of all about the parts of speech. The parts of speech, I will tell you first of all the definition of parts of speech, that classification of words according to their work is called parts of speech. You know that if we are reading anything, we are writing anything, we use different type of words. These words we categorize, and the classification of these words according to their function, according to their work, is known as a parts of speech. Friends, you know that there are 8 parts of speech. So I will tell you kinds of parts of speech. That many there are 8 parts of speech. As you know there are 8 parts of speech. First one is known as a noun we know, it is known as a, in Hindi we say it, sangya. Second one is pronoun, known as sarvanam. Third is verb, kriya. Fourth is adjective, known as visheshan. After that, fifth number, adverb. Adverb known as a kriya visheshan. And sixth number is known as a preposition. Preposition. And seventh is conjunction. We say it samuchya bodhak avyay. And next one and last, interjection, vismayadi bodhak avyay. So students, you have seen here that there are 8 parts of speech. First one noun, second one pronoun, third one verb, after that adjective, next one adverb, after that preposition, conjunction and interjection. Noun sangya, pronoun sarvanam, verb kriya, adjective visheshan, adverb kriya visheshan, preposition sambandha bodhak avyay, conjunction samuchya bodhak avyay, and in last interjection we know it vismayadi bodhak avyay. So we will discuss first of all about noun. What is a noun? Noun. What is a noun? The things which are around you, those all things are known as a noun. The definition of noun is the words which tell something or which have name, they are known as a noun. Simple way we can understand noun is the name of any person, place, animal or things. The second definition we can also write here, noun is the naming words. We can understand the topic noun easily by those definitions. First one given here, noun is the name of any person. It means all type of persons which exists on the earth, they belongs to noun. All the places, all the animals, all the things and many other things which are not seen also known as a noun. Are in simple way you can understand that noun is the naming words. Noun is the naming words. It means the things which have name, they are known as a noun. Students, everywhere in the classroom you look a lot of things: chalk, duster, blackboard, fan, table, chair, door, window, trees, plants, sun, moon, a lot of things. So everywhere you cast your eyes, you can see the nouns. For more, I will tell you some examples of noun as Ram, man, Radha, book, village, sun, etc. So you know that all the words. Okay. Students, I have told you about noun. I told many examples here that all the things in simple way you can understand. The things which are around you, those all things are noun. Second parts of speech is pronoun. Pronoun, you know that pronoun word is made by two syllable, pro and noun. So what is the need of pronoun? Why we use pronouns? First of all, I will tell you that what is the need of pronoun. If we are writing again and again, or we are speaking again and again a noun, so it is not good. It is not looking good. That's why we avoid the repetition of noun again and again. So to avoid the repetition of noun again and again, we use pronoun. So you can understand in simple way that pronoun, we use pronouns at the place of noun. So definition is the words which are used in the place of noun are called pronouns. As example is given here, by example I will tell you. Sentence is Ram is a good boy. Ram is my friend. Students, you know that there is two sentences. Ram is a good boy. Second is Ram is my friend. So you know that there are two times Ram has come. So in second sentence, at the place of Ram, we can write here, he is my friend. So you know that at the place of Ram, we can write he. So what is he? He is a pronoun. And we can avoid the repetition of noun Ram again and again at this place. So you can understand that to avoid the repetition of noun again and again, we can write pronouns. Many examples are pronouns as I, we, he, she, it, you, they, etc. Many pronouns are there. In the sequence, when I will tell you about the pronouns, I will tell you properly about the pronoun and its kinds. Third part of speech, I have told you noun, pronoun, after that verb. Verb, the definition of verb is an action word. Or you can see that a word which tells about any action is called verb. Or in second way, we can say verbs are action words. So in simple way we can understand that the things, the words which tells about any action, they are known as a verb. Verb means any action. In simple way, there are a lot of example of verb as go, come, sleep, run, read, write, a lot of things. So you know that verb is a main parts of a speech which tells about any action. Friends, in next video I will tell you about the kinds of verb also, that there are a lot of verbs and we categorize them also in different type, as linking verb, helping verb, auxiliary verbs, and transitive verbs, intransitive verbs, and a lot of more.